Middlebrooks, I want to have this important discussion about Jordan Belfort. The movie, The Wolf of Wall Street, portrays him as a ripoff. And that's totally and completely inaccurate and illegal. Leonardo DiCaprio's depiction of Jordan Belfort, Wolf of Wall Street, is horrible. I mean, I know it's a fun film and all that, we'll get into that later, but penny stocks today creates millions. And as an example, in the penny stock, the pink slips inside the film, the penny stocks, they show a company Paradigm that's in a garage. But let's look at all the companies that started in a garage. Mattel, the billion-dollar toy company, Harley Davidson, Apple, Microsoft, Disney. I mean, by the way, don't forget, Apple with Steve Jobs started in the kitchen table, migrated to the living room, and then went to the garage. These multi-billion dollar conglomerate companies, the list is incredible, that started in a garage. Hewlett Packard, Nike. So to depict Jordan Belfort as claiming that he did something illegal, because there's a part of the film where they said, where Jordan Belfort, where Leonardo DiCaprio says, was all this legal? And he goes, no, it wasn't. Well, it absolutely was. And it happens today every day. It's called penny stocks. So legitimately, Jordan Belfort could sue, even though he gave up the rights, by damaging the image, the branding, and the entire persona of Jordan Belfort, because the whole movie is a lie. And there were drugs, but it was personal use. It wasn't sold in the street. He didn't move kilos and kilos of cocaine and stuff like that. It was all just personal use. So I know it's a fun film. It's a funny film. 14 Academy Award nominations, and it probably deserved to win. But however, I'm going to be doing the real portrayal of The Wolf of Wall Street. And it's completely different because it's going to involve the truth, which Jordan Belfort deserves, because he went into Manhattan, the toughest shark-eating city in the world, and he didn't just make it. Things like Steve Madden of Yves Saint Laurent, that shoe, the Steve Madden shoe, that hit. And so back when you think about this, whenever cash leaves your hand into someone else's, that's a gamble. Wall Street is nothing more than a massive gamble. So whenever you have cash that leaves your hand into the hand of someone else by a wire, by a bank account, that's a gamble. I don't care what it is. And when from the projects that do hit big, everyone's, yeah, we've made millions and billions. But don't forget, it's a gamble. So when they don't, however, what do people want to do? They want to sue and want their money back, as if they want to take the gambling out of gambling, which is what Wall Street is. So that's the real truth of the depiction of the truth of what happened in Wolf of Wall Street. Jordan Belfort was right. He was maligned. The public's completely deceived. He should have never been indicted. He should have fought it, because he would have won. His father, Rob Reiner in the film, played by Rob Reiner in the film, convinces him to give up. And he shouldn't have, because he would have won. Because there's a stack of papers this thick. If you invest your money in Wall Street in a stock, anything, in a dividend, private placement, that's a gamble when it leaves your hand. And you know it. And so I'm Keith Middlebrook, and I'll always give you the real truth. Stay tuned for more of the truth coming up. I'm Keith Middlebrook. Thank you very much.